Johnson Charles, Puff Duplessis need no introduction, really. Assessment of conditions. The issue here in Guyana at Providence has been, how many do you get in that power play? How do you go about playing in the power play? Can you handle the spin? Not just the spin, what about the skiddy pace as well? It is a fourth game on here. Shot. Must seize upon errors of the bowler, and that error was just being a touch too full. What a shot that is. Absolutely nailed it. A Republic Bank maximum.
Adaptation at its very best. That switch hit. Pumping this one.
Just over 7.5. Oh, 10. Beautiful. Again, almost a carbon copy, you know.
They had an easily win as well. Might have just blown the ball a fraction away from Faf du Plessis. But no question to the degree of turn. Quite significant.
Yep, that's out. It's got to be grounded behind the line. And there's nothing grounded there with the bails lit. Beautiful bowling. And in having that hang time, revs on the ball. There's confirmation. It's got to go for Faf du Plessis. And as I say, carbon copy. Gone at it. There's his shot. He knows how he's going to do it. Had a go a couple of times and a couple of times successful. Four runs. On to 19 now, Johnson Charles. He's got a hold of that one as well. And is hitting with the wind. Brilliant. From Johnson Charles, 31 for one.
Impressive from Johnson Charles, because not only is he showing us an added skill set that he has to switch hit the ball with the turn, but he's also using the conditions here at Providence. That win factor.
Oh, nearly. Just wide of a short fine leg. McCoy can get there. Five done.
Got a stumping. Yeah, hit straight. And the sweep shot you would have thought would have gone a lot squarer, so it's good positioning. It's a good puller of the ball, you know. And that's again in front of square. Really good placement from Akeem Ogis.
Your back foot players will tell you too.
More runs. You've got to be brave, Danny. Batting first, you have to find a way to win. 50 comes up to end the seventh, 51 for one.
Yes, I concur with that, because you have to play your shots. It's about getting something threatening when you bat first. Posting a decent total net on this surface is really 130, 140 upwards.
Charles, leg side with the wind. And just enough to fly all the way for a Republic Bank maximum. This is exceptional striking from Charles.
Watched it sail. He thought he was in business for a moment. And then just had to watch it sail with the breeze.
Crunch. Wide of long on. 50 comes up for Johnson Charles. His second this season. That's nice and clean.
It's leading into the 40s, he was in there and he's out of there quickly now. With a couple of sixes, he's hit.
This could be trouble, could be trouble. Yes, he's gone. So after bringing up his 50, Johnson Charles lured into a false stroke.
50 and is out of here. But it's a change of pace. His cutters into the surface. You think it's a bit of pace on, or extra bit of pace on.
Timed sweetly through that extra cover region. How about that for form? Stumped. Sharp, nifty work from Quinton de Kock.
That'll be fine. Thank you. But, just wonder whether, yeah, bowler and keeper in... sync together and said, look, why don't we just slip one down the leg side and let's push it wide and let's have a go.
His last fight with 7 wickets in hand. Here's Cornwall. Yeah, Tim Seifert, very strong through extra cover. Boundary to start the over. Hello, Tommy Mbangwa. Into the wind, doesn't matter. He's really connected well with that. Another horizontal back shot bringing success.
Done. Yeah, watch closely. And a certain measure of caution taken with trying to make sure that he makes good contact and lifts that over deep mid-wicket for 6.
Top class. That could be the best shot we've seen for the day, maybe for the weekend. Over extra cover off the back foot for 6.
Incredible power of the hips here. You watch him through the hitting zone there. Oh, my goodness. That's a little wide of him as well. You watch this, slowy. So slower delivery, no pace.
Again, hit straight by Ogis. His positioning and placement today has been superb. This is a big over 13 from the 17. So Seifert goes leg side and he goes all the way. This is such a crucial innings. Went pace on this time. This is why David Vista has been brought in. An immediate impact. That is so unorthodox, but it gets the desired result nonetheless. Four more. So that plan not really working, and it's been more to the brilliance of Tim Seifert. Goes straight and given. First time in the overholder, adjusts his line and goes straighter. And Seifert does review, but.
Yep, pitched outside. It's a good delivery. It's a dot.
And that straight plan, I wonder if Holder can commit to it. You understand he doesn't want to go straight to Seifert because he's shown a propensity to hit leg side, but slightly straighter and better result. And good running. They've really put the pressure on the Barbados Royals with their running between the wickets, with their minimal dots in the innings, just 44. Sweet timing.
Hard new ball will allow.
That will be more. And looks like 6 of them as well. So a big finish to the over 13 for none. And there's the short ball. Well controlled by Karim Aline. And it just gets into the boundary. Very lovely from Quinton de Kock. He looks on tonight.
You're surrounded by the best players in the world and you learn from them.
Yeah, that's into the wind and that's big. This is what Karim Aline has done well all season. Shot of the day. This has been brutal ball striking from Karim Aline.
It's an aspect of his game that he's worked hard on.
Goes again. Work for Fatidu. Can't get there though. It's 3 sixes to start the over. That is majestic. Showing us the levers now opening up and going through extra cover. This has been amazing innovation from Quinton de Kock, bringing up the 50 partnership. They have just held up in the pitch and here's the fight back from Joseph, who's got the cock for the second time in 2 days.
Was after him, Alzari Joseph shows the smarts. just to bring that deception with pace off and as well to go wide with his line.
Oh dear. Yep.
Measure the round and undo the work of the opening pair that's been done in the power play. You've got to come and try and put another building block to it. And how he was going to do that was to try and work out.
That edge will do. That'll do. It'll run away. No chance for Alzari Joseph there. Oh, that is outstanding. He's got protection, but it doesn't matter. A little bit too full and too much. Uh-oh, into the wind. And gone. So the change of the bowling has done the trick.
And it seemed he might get it going again. A beautiful shot through the covers. And then has probably tried to hit this too hard.
There you go, there's another. But this one's gone all the way. Republic Bank Maximum. Oh, that's a cracker. Yes, Kevin.
So another look at it. Got this one right. Oh, what about that for turn? And well done on being late to review it.
Just opens up that offside. Really great use of his crease. And good thinking as well. I would ask, on the flip side, does Miller then say, well, let me see Noor out?
Some with hope. Yep, in line and carries on across. Oh, so close. So, so close. You understand why the umpire doesn't give it out. Correct decision there. Had it been given out, though, it would stay out. So fair enough to have a look at it. One for situation in terms of who's batting.
This time straighter, and this time Noor gets him, but he's reviewed it straight away.
There you go, angle just slides across. Yeah, not quite. Umpire Tuckett says got to change his decision, and Miller survives for him to actually strike.
Big, a release of pressure, and it's come with a Republic Bank maximum. That could be four as well. Just a flick of the wrist, he timed it supremely. There is that wicket.
And it's the captain who's gone to his trump card and also taken the catch. A cracker. Couldn't keep it down. Winkled out by...
Whipped wide of long on. And it flies for six. Alec Atenez intervenes with this great shot.
Must look for a boundary.
And he's bowled him. So, a fabulous over.
Just the five singles previously, and you couldn't blame Alec Atenez to try and get on with it. But look at that, lack of bounce. Given what's coming. Oh, hello. Jason Holder, straight as you like. What a very good way to start the penultimate over.
Length. On this occasion,
and always difficult right from the get-go. Change of pace just suddenly, a breaking of the wrist there, little off cutter.
Edges one, it's cultured enough to beat the wicketkeeper. So the boundary comes, slapped, not strong enough, and it's carry pair. Safe hands and a wicket
for the Kings.
Livery, and this really did have to disappear out of the ballpark. Sort of got the length for it too. Was there for that sort of stroke, but the timing wasn't.
Tries that shot to secure a boundary, doesn't get so anticlimactic. You can see at the end of this match number 24, Faf du Plessis and his men